It's Wednesday, and you know what that means? Preferably, that it's time for World War Wednesday. But then again, Dan and Daniel are looking very shocked at the prospect.
Yes,
we were not ready for this. Well, we were still talking.
It's 1 minute past four, so ready or not, you're alive.
Yeah, excellent. Hello guys. Welcome to the second part of the World War Wednesday with Kaiserreich.
Yeah.
So, last time, what happened?
Well, we managed to narrowly avoid the civil war, which I completely blame Daniel for, because he refused my wishes for flamboyant guys in the government. So apparently the country ended up really stable. Yeah.
And apparently you talked with those guys and they told you when the civil war was going to happen.
Yeah, I don't remember exactly, but I think it was like the limit was minus 1,000 political power. And we were on like 960, 980 something.
So we just narrowly escaped it. Because I remember every time we got a good event, right after we like plus 100 and minus 120. So we must have just evaded it by skill of luck.
Yeah. Okay, like.
So, like we still have to rebuild our nation. We talked about this, like we are really big, powerful now. And now when I actually looked at the nation, we're not big and powerful.
We're big, we're just not very powerful yet.
Yeah, look at our divisions. Where's the artillery?
It certainly has enough infantry.
Yeah, certainly. And look at our military industry, 23 factories.
Oh, yeah.
Look at our civilian factories, we can use 22.
Yeah.
We're not big and powerful at all.
No.
So I think I'm going to spend some time actually rebuilding the nation now. We had a good start. Let's make it even better. And good, my shirt isn't completely weird like it is here.
Yeah, it looks super weird on our screen. It's like floating everywhere.
So I think actually we're going to take them down, if I remember correctly, by this focus. Claim Turkestan.
Exactly. So we were considering some expansions while we build up some weak neighbors.
So I think that's basically splitting. I think we'll just split up the army. Wait. Supply. Always look at the supply. Yeah, we don't have good supply here. So no. I'm actually gonna do, let's say, 40 on this front. So wait, first everyone, split in half. Take these half. Touch there and half, just 10 divisions right here. That should be correct. 40 and 10. Excellent. Yeah. Tab.
So, yeah, the reason Daniel is setting up these fallback lines up in the bush is that it's a great way to organize your forces when you want to reorganize which templates and stuff like that, is to kind of keep them in one place when you have a huge nation like Russia.
Come on, this front line's being evil. There we go. So, fallback lines, I love them. Also, just generally setting them up. Since I don't have any resistance to smash down, I don't have everything. Otherwise, I usually use the garrison order. And that went quickly. Oh, it was one of those super short focuses.
Yeah, yeah.
But come on, I'm not ready yet.
Yeah, no, that's actually a thing. They have a bunch of focuses that are not 70 days.
Yeah,
so you have to keep an eye out.
Okay, I can't.
It doesn't say after.
No, but I'm not ready yet, so we'll have delay. And luckily, it seems like there's no timeout. So we can relax a tiny bit.
Good.
So what
of course,
else?
Gives them some more time to prepare.
Yeah, that's true, but I think we still have to do it.
Yeah.
So we can pick one of these four big. It seems like, okay, we can only pick one of these four.
I think we need to start thinking industry in long term here. Right?
Yes, and this is great public work, scripted corps, monopoly companies, war industry, and research slots. So I say let's go this.
Yes.
One corporate state.
How many research slots do we have now? Four?
Three. So finally getting more forward will be important. But what does this mean? State corporatism is a political culture and form of corporatist who adhere to hold that the corporate group, which is basis of society in the state. The state requires all members of a particular economic sector to join officially designated group. Such group attain public status and participate in national policy making.
This is interesting. We couldn't have taken this before we had secured power for Wrangel.
No. So yeah, cool. Minus 100 political power, maybe we can go minus 1,000 now.
Let's not.
So I also want to go for... we have enough. No, wait. This will take 70 days, so we will start go minus a tiny bit. And I would really not like to lose this for any reason. So I'm going to be a bit
we're getting
safe.
Getting like 15% output.
Yeah, exactly. So I'm going to be a No! I don't want cores in that land. God damn it.
Sorry.
I was like, I'm gonna just wait 50 days and then pick. So, popularity rising.
She's
do
good.
We need it? We're at only at 58%,
is good.
So yeah, losing even more political power, and 40 plus.
Yeah, so for people who didn't watch last time, the greatest achievements we have is that we have now control over the the local news system.
Yeah.
And the Catholic Church loves us.
Catholic? Orthodox?
Yeah.
I was like, when did we switch to Catholic?
Never mind.
High part popularity. Boom. So I really like this mechanic, actually, with stability and part popularity actually being integrated with political power.
Yeah.
And this, well, high part popularity being integrated in high party popularity.
Yeah, it actually matters.
So, hint, hint, maybe we know someone who designs vanilla?
Yeah.
So, integrates Brazil.
No, it's cool stuff. it's stuff we've been thinking about doing. Probably not, you know, since we actually control the code, we can do it in different ways, but...
Yeah.
It's actually a really neat way they've done it by switching out ideas and stuff.
So we have there are revolts, just civil wars everywhere in the entire world. So
I blame communism, our enemy.
Oh, it's so communists are our enemies now.
Well, we rooted them out of Russia, right?
Yeah, that's kind of true, actually. So is that going to be our goal? To bring, or maybe not bring back the old state, but at least not have them being communists anymore.
Yeah. I think our end game here is oh my god, those guys are also completely red.
Yeah, these are two different reds.
France and Britain, yeah, but red is red. France and Britain, you know.
What the hell? An Austrian Empire says bye-bye Pope.
No, not the Pope.
So yeah, I think we're kind of ready for this now.
Yeah.
Do we have an air force? Yes, but we don't have any air base. Oh, maybe this one. I doubt that those fighters will actually have the range to actually reach this.
I-15 is one of my favorite planes. It's awesome.
So 47% and 14%. Not the best one, but at least it's better than nothing.
By the way, there's actually a mod. I forgot about that. There's a mod that fixes the flickering flags problem.
Do you have flickering flags?
Yes, oh, yeah. You do.
Yeah,
I was going to try and remember to check that out, but yeah,
people can deal with it. Except we are Japanese.
Yes.
So, is there anything else going on in the chat while we're just waiting? I'm just speeding out the speed force so we actually can have a chance of reading the chat a tiny bit.
Yeah.
Since people were really complaining about me picking the wrong choices always.
Yeah.
Whatever.
There are so many choices though, so it's quite hard to read it just from the focus tree if you've never played them before.
Okay, I think it's actually fine.
Yeah.
Yeah, so excellent. Let's just declare this war then.
Destroy them.
Is the our planes
preparation
arrived?
up to
yes,
snuff?
Yes, this is done. I never assigned units. I never assigned. This was the old plan, so I never assigned units to it.
Oh, well.
43 division. Okay.
Do you even need the...
Oh, what are these units? That's 5 units. Oh, these must have been event spawn units for the civil war that we never used.
Yeah, very likely.
So yeah, we had 13 divisions standing doing nothing.
Yeah, what's our supply like? Can we use them all?
We should probably check. Yeah, it's pretty safe right here.
Yeah.
Some infrastructure might get destroyed, but I think we should build right. They have 7 to 9 divisions.
Shouldn't be too bad. You don't have any artillery.
Let's check the resources right.
It's gonna make pushing hard.
Okay, we'll gain nothing from doing this. We will get 8 military, okay, 8 military factories. That's not too bad when you think about it.
It doesn't
and
hurt.
9 civilian. That will actually increase.
Also, we'll wipe that smug look off of the guy's face as we extend the Russian Empire.
So, declare war and then just execute order. We shouldn't be able to do my high skilled micros right here, but we could just increase speed of doing some of it.
Yeah.
You can, you're attacking there. You are going in right here. No. Like this, and one of the other units go like this. So we'll just try to do this. Oh! Remove NVIDIA pop-up.
Whoops.
I didn't even see it.
No. I was looking at the combat slash.
Yeah. I'm too focused at the game.
Yeah.
What are you doing? The front is over there. Get back there. Oh, maybe it was they retreated because of supply issues. Oops. Might very much have been that. Yeah. And I just forced them to go back right now. And you guys, please, you can actually push in a tiny bit more. Let's you go up. You go there. And yeah, that should be fine.
I think we should try and reorganize our military after this.
Yeah, definitely.
Have some cavalry and stuff for encirclements.
Are you crazy? Cavalry? Motorized? Oh, we never even assigned.
I was just going to say,
right,
do you even have motorized?
No, probably not. Soon.
Yeah.
But we said we're going to go heavy tanks, right?
You said that. I'm not going to take responsibility for your heavy tanks.
So I want to go heavy tanks.
Go for it.
We probably need some
bigger
support.
Is better.
And I'm probably going to set up some artillery too, just in case. So just generally building something we will have use for, maybe not just
by the way, Daniel, research.
Yeah. What's the problem?
Look at our thingy. What are we researching?
Oh.
Is it just
more
the
research
trucks?
Speed, larger front, and trucks.
Yeah.
Let's go back to speed 5. I can't bear playing at such a slow speed.
Go for it.
Yeah. One corporate state. Okay, cool. No event. Maybe end of day. Mm. Oh, I was thinking we were going to get an event that was going to tell me about something.
Nope.
But maybe not. So, this is giving us 15% extra unity, so we'll be up at 100%.
Don't necessarily need it,
no.
Unless there's special
and
bonuses.
And recruitable population 2% and division recovery rate 10%.
We've got like 4.5 billion, so we don't need it yet.
This one.
That looks pretty sweet.
Yeah. 2, 4.
Yeah.
I can't count. 7 civilian factories, 2 infrastructure in 3 areas.
Yeah.
Have we talked about Arshane?
No, I was just going to say, like, before I was going to go, like, infrastructure, bleh. But now, like, with the new patch, I don't know if people have been reading the dev diary today. Or, actually, I think we talked about that one last week. Infrastructure now controls speed of construction in the States. Infrastructure is, like, actually really, really nice now. You really want to take the national focuses with infrastructure because it's going to speed up all your production and stuff there.
I actually went down that path. Solely for the infrastructure, then I realized, I can
but
take
now,
the
now it doesn't
slot.
Matter because we're on the old version.
Yeah.
They're probably gonna switch over hot code wise in the future, though.
Ooh.
But I don't know, probably not when we play mods because, yeah.
Yeah, I guess
we will try to have the patch out a bit early in time for like beta so the modders can have time to actually fix some stuff before actual release.
Youth organization provide volunteers. A youth organization happy to announce the extraordinary number of teenagers have excellent physical tests and were recommended to join our military. Plus 10,000 military.
Excellent.
Nice. Let's see how many have died in this war. 24,000.
Maybe not all of them were teenagers.
We are losing more than they are.
Well,
we only have like 10 times their size.
But you are attacking, you know, generally attacking is not a good idea. It's always easier to defend, and our divisions have no, you know.
No punching power.
There's no
whatsoever.
Punching power. It's like, you know, World War I style attacks going on here.
Well, we were in big civil war. Or, no, we
as
weren't.
As if World War I didn't have artillery.
Yeah.
But, yeah.
So, yeah, we're just trying to break that hold. Let's see. We're going to need motorized, and we're going to need a ton of motorized.
Yeah.
So as soon as we basically have it, I'm just going to build even more of it. And right here, since we don't have a patch, I'm just going to build all my industry right here. Just in case.
No, not the two zones. It hurts.
So we have motorized.
This sounds like a pretty good early one, right?
Maybe I want rocket artillery.
Yeah.
With some heavy tanks.
Yeah, let's
who
let's
cares about artillery?
Just build a glorious division. We get a few of them and they're going to be amazing.
Yeah. I really like that. Few amazing divisions.
Yeah. I mean, I think we're going to be pretty strong anyway, considering we lucked out on the Civil War.
Yeah. Like, if we had planned it, it would have been bad of us.
And I mean, considering our quest to destroy communism here, I also feel like we probably can't just kill every neighbor as well. So you're going to have to kind of roleplay that a bit.
Do we have any communists right here? I don't think so.
No. Not unless they're...
India? Oh!
There we go.
Radical socialists. They have to disappear. So, I think it's time for us to reorganize our military.
Yes, let's drop some templates and clean up our army a bit.
I'm going to just make one big line like this over the general vicinity of Russia, and let's see, large front operations, perfect.
Sweet.
And I think I want to just continue here. I want our land of dreams to be better than the opponents. So, this one, this is a militia division, and I think we will have enough supply, both equipment and manpower in infantry weapons, so we don't really have to worry about it. I would rather make one
could
of these
cavalry. Could be a good garrison one, though.
I would rather make one of these. A garrison division for suppression.
Do they actually get suppression from militia, though? What is the...
This is 12. Let's make this 6 big and see what happens. And the suppression right here is 6.
So okay, we'll so not a big advantage, but it's cheaper, right?
Yeah, it's half of it.
Yeah.
Actually, it's half-half. So we can have twice as many of these divisions standing around.
Yeah, I mean, it's not terrible.
We can keep it. Okay.
Yeah.
With fire support. This one with artillery. So we don't really need this one if we want to go for more artillery.
Yeah.
With recon support, I think we're going to remove this one. You can always just add recon to that one. Engineer support.
You have 100 XP now. You can do things.
Yeah. Engineer support, the same thing with that one. But we apparently have some divisions with it. So I'm just going to tell everyone, become the normal one. Yeah. So we can actually change out stuff. So fire support, you're done. Actually... Should everyone at least have one artillery in support?
Yes. Why not?
It will be quite expensive to actually change out everything. It's 24 times 93. So almost 2,400 artillery.
Yeah, but it's nice.
This could just be a meat shield grinder for really good divisions.
Yeah, I mean, it depends how you like. I kind of like my infantry to be about the same, all of them.
Yeah.
And then focus my money on like armor and stuff like that. But you could also split up half the stuff you have, right? And go garrison for garrison duties.
And here's one motorized division. Yeah, I can probably make
tank one. Yeah, we want to turn this into tanks, right?
So heavy tanks, that's perfect. Save.
So beautiful.
It's not motorized division anymore.
What should we call this? Fury of the Tsar.
You always give some, like... Oh, wait, it's an English keyboard. No. That.
Yeah.
I'm just going to call it age. Not that one. Not that sign. Not that sign. Okay, that sign. Whatever. Age tank. Heavy tank vision.
I feel like it's not glorifying the Tsar enough, but... fine.
Let's see. So far, I miss. Has Japan attacked Russia yet? So, Japan will apparently attack us.
Oh, really?
I do not like that, actually. No. We don't have any division stationed right here. So I think I'm just going to take some of these units, let's say 38 of you. And let's find a decent commander. Wrangel, okay. Yeah, let's go on vacation to Asia.
Yeah.
And just
I like how
right
we keep
here.
Sending him around.
Russia controls Central Asia. Stability comes back to Central Asia since the fall of the Tsarist Russia. Tribes and hordes were fighting each other. Now Central Asia is border and much secure, and we can strengthen ourselves in the Urals. Plus 300 political power.
Woohoo!
Da 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 da. Da
more
da,
toasters
da.
To the people.
No, less toasters.
Less toasters.
Guns. Guns don't kill people. Tsars do. So, no decisions right here. No theorist. Intel minister. God. There were some stuff.
Yeah.
So industrial, most of them apparently still seem to lack. Still, that's important actually to say.
Yeah, this I mean, it's alpha.
So it's still being worked on.
Yes.
But infantry manufacturers. Oh.
Yeah.
Oh, I like that one.
Yeah, I don't think we even looked at this last time.
No, it feels like we didn't.
So,
oh God, there's a ton of stuff.
What can improve our amazing.
So, first, tanks.
Exactly, our amazing super tanks.
Tanks. Yeah, heavy tank producer. Production cost plus 10%. So a tiny bit more expensive, but 6% attack and, soft and hard attack. Do we want that?
I think you're not going to have so many divisions, so it's probably okay. Yeah. But so you have medium tank producer.
But those are specifically for those sort of tanks. So I think that's the only one that is affecting heavy tanks.
Go with it.
And I think we want some tank commander too, if possible.
Mm-hmm.
Maneuver. Oh, here.
Yeah.
It's us.
Oh yeah. Yeah. We're doing everything now.
Yeah. We're leading an army, we are the rule of the nation, and deciding our tank tactics.
Yeah, stuff like this never went wrong in other countries, like never. Say Germany.
When one guy decided everything.
Or tried to, at least.
Punished his generals. No, he didn't decide this with me. Stop.
Clearly, Daniel will not make the same mistake.
Never. He's in command, not me. I'm just sitting here.
Yeah.
So, will we get any tank divisions quite soon? We should have enough resources, basically, in everything, but we seem to be missing a tiny bit of rubber, and I think we want to trade it with Dutch East in this.
Yeah.
Great public works. Excellent. Oh, God, that's just beautiful.
That is a lot of nice stuff.
Yeah. And then we could go, well, for
still pretty good.
Three more civilian factories and two more military. Yeah. And this is six more military.
By the way, go up to monopolies. Was that a timer? It costs political power.
Yeah, political power.
Okay.
But that should be fine. We're going to get,
yeah,
hopefully not, if we don't get a horrible event once again that destroys our political power. Austrian Empire declared war on Iron Guard Romania.
Yeah.
That's interesting. The Czech Republic, Grand Army Reformation, reinforced the KUK Army, Interventionist. Oh, Italian Republic. So they just.
That's a truce.
So they were just reformed by Austrian, yeah. Austrian Empire. Okay. German Empire. Oh, wait, it's Austrian Empire now.
Yeah.
Wasn't it Austrian-Hungarian?
I think so. Stuff going on. I assume there's a lot of events going on down there.
Yeah.
We were really focused on our own stuff.
Greater Austrian Empire. So it might have been this one that actually removes.
Yeah.
Or am I weird? Hurrah for the Tsar, Daniel. Yes. Hurrah.
Hurrah. There were a lot of different kings.
Wow. So, okay, we have to remember, always when we take a nation, we get claims
power
on that, and, well, yeah.
Yeah.
Minus 100 blue power. God damn it. So, how are tank division? Do we soon have one? 59 heavy tanks and 4 motorized are still needed.
Can I at least name the first division, Fist of the Tsar?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes, you can.
Good.
So I even want to increase it even more. Like my favorite tank division.
I think we can make
like
this fun. How far have you got until we get the rocket artillery here?
It should be. I want something like this, at least.
30 width.
And then we can add something like rocket artillery, so it becomes 40.
Yeah.
So 3 military factories. Let's see how long before that rocket artillery. 59 days. So a tiny bit more.
Yeah.
Are there anything we're generally missing a lot of, or is it just heavy tanks? We are not producing an air force. That's
you're missing one tactical bomber.
Let's just set this up so I actually have to look at it time and time again, so I don't forget about it.
Yeah.
Since we need to research better planes too. Down.
No.
Come on.
Oh, it was so close.
Oh, actually, no, we wouldn't. That's minus 60, 50 more.
Yeah.
Dun, 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 dun. Well, so their 150 blue power that we saved up before just wasted.
Yeah.
Unpopularity rising.
Again.
Yeah. Nice. But we can still go to very high part popularity, which will increase it by 1. But we still have to spend this 40, and we're going down minus again now. So I'd rather just save up a tiny bit. Is there anything we can pick that would increase our political power?
Well, Entente, what about the stuff on the left? There's a bunch of Tsar things going on here. Oh, we maxed out all of those. Yeah. All right.
And far to the right, French commissars.
So we can pick the plans.
Mechanical warfare plan. Continue modernization.
Mobilization of the masses. What's that? On the right there. Next
Here. 3% more recruitable population. So we can get a ton of manpower if we want to. Here, reform, different. Okay, this is three plans. We can only pick one of them. So basically, same thing like
before. Do we care about the Navy yet, though?
No, not really. Yeah.
Maybe for later.
Vladimir Pushet dies. The Red Flood.
What is going on here?
Okay, I'm just gonna pick this. Yeah, let's grab it.
Okay, so Lithuania's most famous impressionist writer recently published a new book, The Red Flood.
What does it mean? Much like a famous work. Okay, it's a book. The novel takes place in an alternate timeline where Bushlot offensive was successful and knocked Austria-Hungary out in the Weltkrieg. Okay, this leads to a chain event that results in intense victory. Germany is engulfed by revolution and becomes a syndicate nation. So this is an alternate history writer who writes about alternate history that isn't like history.
Not, that was a bit too alternate for me, but
yeah,
yes.
Something like that. And supported by Black Hundreds, he becomes totally an alternate dictatorship. Oh, so in this story, Russia becomes
Germany.
Basically,
he's written an old history story about
Germany becoming Russia and Russia becoming Germany. Yeah. This book is circulates horror description of cruel war and crimes. Okay. Is it trying to make the universe as bad as possible?
Yeah. So the chat's asking what Canada's up to. Let's find out.
Let's just pick one more focus here. War industry.
War industry.
And was this Rocket Artillery done
yet? No, not yet.
Not just yet. So I think I want... Well, let's just finish that one off. Yeah. So... Commonwealth of Canada, Trans-Canada Airlines.
They got Edward in power now.
Yes, I'm pretty sure they had that in the
episode. It was his father before.
Okay. Yeah, so King Edward the Eighth.
Does he come with any fascist leanings?
I don't know. I don't think so.
Yeah.
It doesn't seem like it. They only have 6%. The liberals have 75%, or market liberals.
All right.
And they are still in Entente, and everything seems big. Trans-Canada Airlines.
Because, you know, in theory, there are allies, right? Because this is the rightful heirs of Britain, now held by despicable communists.
Let's see, does anyone like us? I don't think anyone in the entire world actually like us.
Oh, I like that's you, Daniel.
Integrates Brazil likes us.
That's something.
Okay, here we have. So, by their opinion of us. So, we have a couple nations. Iron Guard, like us. Oh. Republic of Lithuania. Brazil, Chile.
The Pacific States of America.
Queen Empire.
Can we go to... Oh, is that after the Civil War? Oh, I see.
So, you like us. Can we do something then? Oh. I don't think we can actually send any...
You can theoretically lend-lease them some stuff in the Civil War, but I'm not sure...
You mean infantry weapons?
Yeah, I don't know about
that. That's the only thing we have. Oh, we haven't actually done this one. We kind of need to do that. 39. Get weapons too.
Yeah.
We need that extra research slot really quickly.
Yeah, we can't be far off now.
No. God, so many people are dying. Stop dying, please.
Yeah. you were looking at the war before when we were like testing out some stuff. And it was like, Dan, check this out. This is not a clock. This is casualties sticking up.
Oh yeah, that was horrible.
Yeah,
and it didn't tick like 1,000. It ticked like 4, 5, 4, 5, 6, 6, 6.
I think a lot of overruns, maybe.
Yeah. So research slot. Let's take weapons 1, and we can now change production a tiny bit. I'm gonna pull this one down, pull that one down, and pull. Now you can be at 2, and I want you to start producing rocket artillery. If I forget about it, I forget about it.
Yeah.
Wait, why is he here?
Because...
Designed by...
Brunger. So he actually affects the...
Armored. Motorized, 10% more soft attack.
Wow, that's super good with these ones.
That's going to be insane. And let's see, do we have a first tank division? It should be placed right here at Moscow. So, no, they're still training. Okay. We still have 11... Okay, we just got enough tanks for this. But that means 2 lines.
Nice. Can we also, for my role-playing fields here, make them elite status?
Okay, then. Yes. Yes.
There we go.
I think we also want to add recon and engineer to them, just for those general bonuses everywhere. And let's save that. That's going to take some more time than to train, but I really like to add recon and engineer to them.
Yeah.
Just those extra bonuses when attacking forts, when getting over rivers. It just negates the penalties tanks have just a little bit, but it's enough.
Totally worth it.
Especially when you've upgraded them. It's amazing then.
Here's a question. So the chat's going like, you know, we actually don't have that much oil. Do we have any neighbors who can nab some oil off?
Nab some oil off. Let's see. Yes, we have.
I mean, we wouldn't.
We have the Don Kuban Union.
Hmm.
But do we have any focus that would let us just nob them? No.
No.
Claim Sinkian, intervene in the Sino-Japanese War.
Which hasn't started yet.
Okay, here. Cost reduction. Here, the question, the Don Kuban Union.
Oh, so we get a lot of cores and there's an event firing about it. What to do with it?
Okay, Germany is busy in demand concession. Okay, so if they go to war, we can do a really quick focus of 7 days and demand some stuff from them.
Oh, that's cool.
Right,
so we'll have to remember that one.
Yes, so we'll see. The Third Balkan War, okay.
I mean, there is stuff going on, like Austria is at war, right?
Yes, Austria is at war. They have their entire Balkan War.
Yeah.
War industrial expansion, so please, research slot, where are you? Wait, I can't pick. Oh, we need to grab this one too, apparently.
Okay. Oh, well.
A bit delayed then, but we need it.
Yeah.
And there was something else I wanted to do. Something else. I don't think we need one complete full of it. I think this should probably be enough. Right.
We
now
just
remember.
Need some extra boost.
Synthetic refinery. Why haven't we researched it?
Mm.
We could have probably used it before. Then we wouldn't need to train for this. Or trade for this. So, but for now, let's trade. I just fix that.
How many civilian factories do we have now?
I'm just gonna add this and this and heavy tank. You're gonna get one more row. Cool. Civilian factories. We have 62.
Okay.
We're trading away with 4 of them and 28 for consumer goods. Mm. All right. We need to fix this too. Just getting that extra stability is just so good. -2% consumer goods, 5% more factory output, and, well, 10% more natural unity. Yeah, well, if we're so badly that those 10% is going to matter, then we have lost, but it's still nice to have.
Yeah, it's a reason not to burn the points.
It seems like Sergio is saying, why get synthetic refineries if you can just invade the causes?
Exactly. The question is, though, do we want to do that now, or do we want to?
I think we want to wait.
Germany is going to get into trouble, so we can kind of
demand
speed
stuff.
Things up.
Heavy tanks, you are very far ahead of time. I think I want to pick something that makes it some research bonus, then pick it ahead of time.
Yeah.
But there was something we were going to do with this research slot.
The extra one, you mean?
Weapons 2, no, that was.
Weapons 2 is running. You're running doctrines already.
Yeah. We could always go right here and grab another level right here. Oh, right. I want field hospital and maintenance. Those heavy tanks are going to be destroyed.
Yeah.
Quite quickly.
Do you feel like you need a hospital despite our manpower reserves?
Hospital, I would actually avoid. They're quite expensive in both most motorized supply and support equipment.
Yeah.
So we will let the Russians do what they do best. Die.
I was going to say drive trucks, but okay.
Okay. Die and drive trucks.
Yeah.
We only need 1% right here to maybe have a chance to trigger the very high part popularity. Whoa. I really don't like this. It's like big events with free options. So, Trans-Siberian crisis. Horrible news. A train full of Russian citizens have been massacred by bandits on the Mongolian sector. People are shocked and act barbarous and demand immediate response from the government. This could be an opportunity to reset control over the far eastern sections of the railroad, but we must tread carefully. Baron Ugin von Sternberg, Supreme Khan of all Mongols, is unhinged and may not take kindly to interference.
Yeah, I think they've gone with the fact that he's basically completely off his nutter. So
I think it was good that we actually just reinforced.
Should we bring civilization to barbarism?
There is only one right answer. Yes. And let's add a couple more units right here.
Let's save the heavy tanks for a more suitable area of war.
Was going to say, let's bring over the first heavy tanks, but okay.
No, I mean, we only have one division, right? So
no, we don't even. Now we have one division.
Now we have one. Have you renamed it?
No, I was just going to let you go. Have the honor. It's Tsar Wrangel now.
It's so beautiful.
Mongolia shakes fist.
Tsar is the S, right? There you go.
Yeah.
Fist of the Tsar, and he shall lead us to victory.
And let's... So maybe we should have...
Be careful and micro that one so it survives. Yeah.
So, you are going to be assigned right here, I think.
Actually, what happens? Is the war right on if we pick the option?
I don't know.
Do we want to move into...
I'm just guessing right now. So, Sergei Makarov have the command of the Fist of the Tsar.
Yeah.
So, not the Tsar itself, but... Yeah.
Yeah, but... So, he's got the armor expertise.
Demand a formal apology from the Mongolian government. Yeah, we can't do that. Enough, we demand full surrender of our Trans-Siberian Railway. Okay, we gain a couple of claims.
Mm-hmm.
And we shall bring civilization where there is barbarism. Send the troops.
Actually, what was the difference there? It looked
Mongolia gets the Russian attack.
Uh-huh.
And Russia declares war on Mongolia.
So we will want to be in position for this.
Yeah. Hopefully, they don't pick an option. I think we have about 2 months on us.
Those mountains look scary.
So please just fix this. You're not allied with anyone. Yes, you are. Tibet.
Oh, no.
Oh, here. So we'll have a nice small expansion. Okay, I can't show right here. I need to show like with the mouse, actually. So yeah. We'll have a nice expansion like this entire area. And we might... That might be our... Well, actually, will
might
that
be
make...
Our ticket to...
And we reach the communist.
Yes.
That's perfect.
Yeah, let's
and we can
it.
Also maybe... Just bring Bhutan to our glorious empire and let them have the communist. Because
yes,
I wonder what kind of awesome name they are named right here.
I hope it's going to be something dragon related.
Yeah, me too. So I'm going to give us a couple more days and then I'm going to clear it and then just let the troops. So I was busy with something else over here first, and
we're gonna work on some organization as well. I don't know if we're finished that.
We're gonna do this research slot.
Whoops! Not one step back.
All right. Exactly. Everything is going as planned.
Of course.
This is the I think a hashtag blame Daniel is
really so someone typed that. I haven't logged into this computer.
People are
good.
Reload, never.
Wow.
Nearly as bad as DDR Green.
Event.
We will have more tanks.
Such event cheating, Daniel. Actually, for you had a little bit more time.
We just make it sure that these tanks actually get.
Yeah.
So we demand a formal apology. We did not get political power or anything. But the Tsar is now. Yeah, that's this.
That's
is just
role play as if we've done.
No, this is a sneaky tactic. We were like, we demand apology. They apologize. But now we're justifying war against them. They would be like, oh, what happened? He's like super surprised. They're not going to expect it at all.
The I don't know. Yeah, I mean, he has the spirit of the great Khan. I'm pretty sure he can foresee this.
But will he? I don't think so.
We will see.
People also said he was barking mad.
Yeah, but...
So, let's fix this.
Great men of vision are usually... Ooh, motorized. With
oh, God. This is going to cost quite a bit.
Yeah...
But I think it's going to be worth it.
Maybe this is when we split off, so only the fist gets this.
No. So, we can actually add this.
You can actually add more. Didn't you want to upsize it as well?
Yes, I do want to. Let's see.
Heavy I feel tanks. Like we really need maintenance company for this one as well.
Yeah, we are fixing maintenance company.
Yeah.
Okay, yeah, everything is going to be fine, even if we increase it by this much.
Yeah.
So that's going to be a 332 extra soft attack.
Nice.
Come up with 35, so we have a couple more things we can add if we want to. And yeah, it's going to be beautiful. These are not just yet ready. And maintenance, you are on your way. Excellent.
By the way, maintenance company is going to be probably you're going to have to put some more effort into it for the next patch. Rebalance the levels a bit so you can no longer completely avoid attrition by maxing it out and stuff like that. Because when I had balanced it last time, I actually forgot about the base bonus to it. So it was off by a bit.
So more volunteers. Awesome. Yeah. New researchers. Oh, one more. Slot instantly.
Nice.
So when you finish one of these trees, you get it was just only this one that gets it so late.
So here's the question. Do we care about the air stuff if we're going to go into Asia?
Well, I'm researching more airplanes. Heavy aircraft. There's nothing we can do. Okay, fine. Oh, wait, that's going to remove from the highest one we have. Mm. Maybe that was a bad idea. Because I still want to keep...
I think we've got some padding, right?
Oh, wait, what's did we lose limit? This one? Or did we never have it? No, I don't think we had it.
I'm not sure.
Okay, good stability at least. Very good stability, please. Yes. That's right, Daniel, play it off. let's see, is that fascists or is monarchy no longer merged with fascists? Well, we are nationalist populists.
Yeah.
So I guess some kind of fascism?
I wouldn't call it fascist.
No.
Despite the evil
this
thing.
Authoritarian democracy, yeah. That's fascist.
Yeah.
Just think about it. Hitler was voted into parliament.
Yeah.
Totalitarianist.
Just because you get the votes doesn't mean it was...
Yeah. So here, encourage railroad construction. Oh, this would be really good.
Yeah, not...
In the nightly build.
Yes.
Encourage hospitals and school construction.
It's only 80.
Yeah. Military factories, yeah, I can like
it's
that one.
Three of them is pretty good.
Or one civilian factory and four infrastructure and political power.
I still think military.
Yeah, I think so too. And these three factories are going to be set up right here and right there. Actually, they're not because they're instantly assigned right there. But the next ones.
I love how much motorized rocket artillery you're pumping out.
Yeah, five a day. We need it. Definitely. Let's see. Wait, it's under motorized right here, I think. Yeah. No? Actually, we don't have a picture for it.
It's upstairs. Oh, here. Second one.
Oh, I'm blind sometimes. No, I don't want that. Oh, good. We'll take first that one and then...
Balance out.
The Siberian crisis is over. Whew. Yeah. It's definitely over.
So what's, like, what's the timer on even justification
tricking
here?
We're even tricking the newspaper in our own nation. They're like, the Siberian crisis is over, relax.
Your masterminding of the situation is going to work out.
Yeah, totally. And why is time always going so quickly?
Yeah, maybe we should try for an extra hour next week.
Yeah, I think so too. But does he think so? I don't know. Next week?
Next week?
Can we talk about next week?
I don't know what you want to say about next week, but if you want to stream more Kaiserreich next week, starting at 3 instead of 4, that's probably doable.
Probably doable.
Yeah, I mean, I think I have time next week. So
cool.
Well, we'll look into it. We were talking about it today, but we kind of realized too late.
So if it doesn't happen 2 hours next week, blame Anders.
Yeah.
That's the one thing to... remember from this session.
Hashtag blame Anders.
I don't think that's true at all. But yeah, no. Let's plan for 2 hours next week, and if that doesn't happen, we'll make sure that me or Zeke tweet about it. We're gonna force Zeke to tweet about it.
Because I feel like next time is gonna be when the fist of the Tsar takes off. You know.
Yeah. I thought we were gonna say so. We will see that blame Daniel.
Yeah.
Okay. Kremlin project. Kremlin project. We must avoid lagging behind our rivals in nuclear fission, the most advanced modern sciences. Okay. I think there was something else we want to do first. Okay, this one is pretty cool.
Yes.
So I'm going to do this one too.
Oh yeah, exactly. Because if we want, we might want to wait though. Like,
but we're the Russian beer. We have enough troops for both fronts.
All right, sure.
So here.
I thought you wanted to wait on the one where we kind of sneak in with Germany and stuff, right?
Oh, but this is one after.
Oh, okay. Right, so we open the way.
Wait, Kharkiv's direction. Where's... Kosovo, very history part of Russia. The people lived. Yeah. Okay, cool. All right. It's just a like it's beginning event, or something.
Yeah.
It's probably gonna declare war with like the entire Entente or something. And I'm just oh god, screwed up once more. Because still we have to remember these infantry units suck.
Yeah.
So I'd rather not go to war with them, even though we have our heavy tanks right here who are godlike if you compare with the rest of our army.
This remains to be seen, because you're going to be stomping into those mountains.
Like I said before, we are not going over the mountains, we're going through them. Just shoot enough times and we'll get through them. With this amount of rocket artillery, what 100 rocket artillery is going behind the tank. It should be possible.
Yeah, I mean, what's the attack penalty there in mountains?
Let's not look at it. But we can do this.
Yeah.
Just 10% more fort attack.
Yes. Defense.
I like it. And modify government. Let's save some political power, because I have a bad feeling about this for some reason.
Yeah, whenever we've attacked people, there's been events that we kind of need to deal with. So let's save some.
And this is now done. What about that timing?
Exactly. So what time we got?
Potential enemies, Mongolia and Tibet.
Let's rock it.
Right, you wanted to check the penalties.
I'm not sure I wanted to, but...
Okay, let's see.
It's
in forest, 20%. Yeah. In hills, 6%. In mountains, 11%. So forest almost. But we should just be able to burn that through.
Yeah, burn it.
Oh, there's a forest there. Rocket artillery, can you just remove it, please?
Yeah.
Remove?
Yeah.
Okay.
For if you don't know, these are not all of the. This is what makes it different from infantry.
Yeah.
There's also a base penalty in certain terrains like mountains that makes it bad for everybody. So this is to compare it to other troops.
The extra stuff. So how are our guns doing? The Mongolian troops are really good, apparently.
Well, even are they? Are they?
You
they
need
the
to
infantry?
Just throw in your troops. We're gonna do what we do best, throw in troops until, we are walking over. Okay, we're even getting pushed back. Apparently.
Considering our aspirations, perhaps we actually should have gone for some mountaineering troops.
Yeah, and let's send the tanks on some expeditionary trip to the other parts. And let's see if we can get a massive surround right here. New troops, half of you. Wait, you're attacking? No? You are attacking. Half of you. Try to get down here. So these guys will hopefully... Okay.
Just looking at those guys going through there, I'm getting like some sort of pain in my internal gearbox, you know.
Come on, just... There, move right there. Okay, cool. Then we just have to micro a tiny bit, because I have a feeling this will go much, much worse if I don't micro at all, because, we are losing. And how many men have we lost at that short time? 26,000 men. That was quick.
Yeah.
And you guys are not attacking, which you must be.
We actually have some air bases here. We don't have any castles of any kind, do we?
No.
Because that might help. The scale
actually,
better.
Let's actually assign them to this position, which seems to be worse.
Yeah. The fighters aren't going to help much, but the castles.
Okay, half of you.
Oh, don't get encircled.
Okay, let's see. German Empire threatens Russia. Okay, the Kaiser has made it clear that his empire will fully support the independence of the Kosovo nation if any nation tries to interfere. It would be unwise to underestimate them, despite the troubles they are facing at home front. How should we react to it? Who cares? So they get mad. They can't get an event to attack us.
They could. I mean, they're not necessarily... Are they going to end up in trouble? This is the problem with alternate history, right?
Yeah.
I don't know what's going to happen.
I'm just thinking here.
Kind of don't want to mess with the Kaiser, considering we hate everybody who's around him.
But Germany's business demand concession. What is this?
Exactly. It sort of implies they're going
Germany
to get
locked into
a
deadly new Valkyrie, it's time to push for consensus. Surely Germany don't want a new two-front war. Okay. And this is the don't compare to Russian or military staff claims. Okay, so it seems like this might be a more let's go to war right now.
Yeah.
And this one seems to be all right.
I mean,
I think we want to be that person right now.
Yeah, I mean, we are doing that. So let's
not make them mad right now.
Not right now. Let's wait for them to be busy and then make them mad.
Not Germany blocks Caucasus. Okay, we might have just screwed ourselves.
Yeah, also that.
Oh, and now I forgot about fixing this tank division. You are supposed to attack right there and just hinder us being surrounded by all fronts. But that's not working as good anymore.
No.
What the hell is with that division?
I don't know what it's doing.
But this is going much better. We're having just too many troops for them.
I think you're going to have to link up to the tanks if you can.
Yeah, I am going that way at least. Now let's see, what else could we pick right here? That is kind of a good thing. We could always go this one, 10% recovery rate.
That's good.
Pretty good thing.
There's also one for mechanized warfare there. That might be a good...
Okay, people are saying that I blew it. So that might be that we actually can't do anything.
Just gonna have to kill the Kaiser.
Urga has fallen. We have finally seized the Mongolian capital. No, we don't even have it anymore.
Oh well. Game core. Look the gift horse in the mouth.
No. We're seized control. Okay. Let Mongolia join us on our terms.
I kind of, you know, like the mad leader of the Mongols.
So, should they join us?
Yeah.
Mongolia accepts. Good.
I hope we didn't get a new leader of Mongolia.
Okay, order Mongol to release Tantua. Tantua will be Russian once more. They are still Mongol for all we care. I think it should just be our land.
Yeah, I don't know what's actually good there, but...
So, the Mongolian Empire is left and...
No, we lost the mad guy.
But still, I can like having a puppet right there.
Yeah.
It's another blocker and they have quite many troops, which are apparently pretty good.
Yeah.
Which we... Well,
what happened to the Tibetan alliance, by the way? Are they...
1 second. Okay, cool. No faction.
Okay.
Have a truce with Russia. Okay, that was the only thing. So let's just pull back all our troops now from the front, and we have united... Well, united some of our lands again. Yeah. It's like, I wasn't that excited about killing them. We gained some resources. And, well, we wouldn't have received that much manpower either. So it was basically...
Let them self-manage.
All right, you are not going to be assigned over there. You're going to be assigned right here. Let's remove all fronts. And then just assign you right here, just in case. And, well, you can get 10 more divisions. Yeah. Since this side is going to have the tanks.
Yes.
So, the two in question. And the Turks next to Mongol have played important functions. No!
No, it's ours.
Yes.
Oh, well, that costs 100, but...
Russian Railroad, plus 300 more.
Nice.
So we definitely got made a political power back.
Yeah.
Intel Minister. Oh, right. We looked at this before. Yeah. We could at least assign one. It might do something.
Yeah.
We need the, Nationalist Populist then. So here, Boris. Welcome to the Sito government. And company.
So
right,
gives
here.
Us one more slot to use.
Oh, infantry equipment plus 16%.
Oh, wow, that's incredibly OP. Maybe
yes,
we should have that.
I think we should. Maybe we should.
Considering, okay. I don't think we're going to afford to put artillery in everywhere. So,
yeah, that's very, very, very true.
But maybe we should start splitting the some of the infantry up in, like, you know, the guys who get the artillery and the guys who don't.
Yeah, or I kind of want to have at least one artillery on everyone.
Okay, so support on everybody, or?
Yeah, some kind of that. Let's move down this, and oh god, the clock.
Oh, what we got? No, oh, yeah.
Not a lot
five,
more time.
5 more minutes.
Yes. And is this just completely blocked for us now?
I think so.
Oh no, when Germany declares war, we can do this one.
Alright.
So we can still get...
Let's hope for that then.
Or when Germany gets into a war. I think there should be a war coming up quite soon with,
maybe.
I think, like, okay, someone right here. Like, this probably escalates to the Weltkrieg.
Looks like Austria is not doing so well, though.
No, definitely not. Let's see, centralized empire.
Can we look at the war in the overview?
Yes, we can.
See how much they've lost.
So, yeah. Right here.
Oh.
More volunteers, thank you. So they lost 350,000 men.
Well, everybody else has been bleeding a lot more, though.
Yeah, so
combined.
They might make a comeback still, but they're straight outside.
Yeah.
But they're pushing back, or at least one province.
Maybe
they are pushing in right here. So.
Okay, maybe Austria is winning this.
I don't know. We'll see.
Romania seems to be hitting though.
Modified government once more.
Hmm.
School of Defense, we have School of Psychology. Oh god, there's so
many.
Are
you sure you want to burn all our political power though?
All right, because we're probably going to get... Yeah. No, no, we got course, so we shouldn't get that.
We got
that.
Course already, okay, so...
I think so,
yeah, go for it then.
But right here, we have something more.
What's this mechanical
warfare? Oh, right, here's the one I want. Oh. Reformed Army.
Okay.
We have not completed that one.
Armor Tech, but that's not the tie ahead of... Actually, we're not that far off now.
Why can't we pick that
What one? Does this one do? Mechanical Warfare.
Research point for encryption, decryption, and computer.
Oh, okay.
But why can't we do this one? Reform the
You must rapport with Markov. Which is the rightmost one, yeah.
That's sad.
Yeah. Hint to modders. That stuff works a lot better if you group it into the actual pre-requirement.
So here, National Armored School. And we can't do that either? No. We have the masses.
Yeah.
Standardized equipment. So yeah, I guess we can do this one. That will negate the extra bonus.
Yeah, I mean, reduce the production cost is great.
So, but we got plus 10% because of the soft attack bonus.
Yeah.
And now
I still take that for 16% attack bonus though.
Yeah, definitely. SARS, what kind of filth is this? It's 1940. Everyone should be equally starving.
No, we are. This is a happy nation.
Right. I completely forgot to add.
Oh. Okay.
Yeah, that's fine.
Yeah.
Let's add it. Oh, we only have 23% organization. So I'm going to add one more pile of motorized. And see if that.
Yeah, I feel like those trucks are miss. I mean, they're not exactly helping speed here, are they?
Well, no. What is really dragging down our speed so much?
The heavy tanks?
Yeah, but we can fix that. Actually, we can fix that.
I don't know, how much faster is the next level?
Let's double check.
You're not that far off.
This one is... I can't see speed.
6 kilometers.
Oh, yeah. Right. But we can always spend some experience points upping that.
Yeah.
And I think actually I will do that. When possible.
Yeah,
300 days.
We just...
Yeah, let's do it.
You want to do it? All right.
Yeah. We're going to continue here. Vast offensive.
We had the research as well.
Oh.
All right, no, but we can take that. Sorry. Yeah.
And let's see. Chief of Army. All right, we had someone here. Oh, look here. Armored Spearhead Doctrine.
Yeah.
And here, School of Maneuver. Even more armor.
Yeah, but it doesn't look like you can pick him.
Oh, we
need certain ruling parties.
Oh, too bad. Too bad. I was like, can you stack this so much? That's artillery. We can't pick that one. But we can pick this one.
Yeah, he's not bad.
Von Rommel.
Is he a relative? I don't know.
I don't know, but Von Rommel it is. So we're just going to stack so many bonuses on our heavy tanks. So the heavy tanks are going to be super heavy. So we're going to just be a driving force.
The Fist of Tsar is going to be unstoppable.
Yeah. But I think this is pretty much what we have time for today.
Yeah.
That was kind of anticlimactic. That was kind of imagine it's a big, great war this session, but apparently not.
Apparently not. I thought Europe was going to go into flames.
Yeah, me too.
Arguably it is, like in the Balkans, yeah. But
we're kind of waiting on the Germans. I thought the Weltkrieg was going to happen.
Yeah.
Maybe we have to do some kind of act first to make them...
Let's unstabilize the world a bit then for next.
Yes, but and hopefully it will be 2 hours. So yeah. We'll definitely have time to just make the world burn.
Yeah. Let's find out what Germany isn't protecting around here and go for that.
Yeah. And I think maybe we can just...
Could also be tension based. I mean, we're only at 4 now. So maybe if you just do another war, it's going to fire off something.
Let's see, do you have anything that is kill Germany? Because that would be kind of nice.
Road to war, is that limited by anything?
Fortified German border, revanchist propaganda, demand Alsace-Lorraine, so that one.
Well, under that you got.
After?
Under your tooltip.
What?
Under the tooltip, take down Germany.
So, October 1939, so they can do it now. They've just avoided it for now. It's going to take 70 days, so we'll see what happens. National focus, okay, not yet. I'm just waiting. Let's see, they are pretty goddamn strong.
Yeah.
So this would be a very even match.
Not with our support, you know.
No, but we will first demand a bit from Germany.
Yeah, I mean, I hope Germany understands our united struggle against communism, though, which I'm not sure if the Kaiser does.
Yeah.
We'll see. We'll have to take them all out.
And I apparently have serious reading issues.
You do?
Yes.
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 I'm not sure which serious issues they are, but...
And there, that war ended. Not really a white peace. It seems like they were forced back a bit. So probably another event signed peace.
Yeah. But yeah, Kaiserreich has a lot of event-based peace deals.
The new Austrian lands. But yeah, if
Deutschland rules the waves.
Oh, cool.
Do they?
I don't know.
In this part of history, maybe they do.
Probably.
Guess what time it is.
Yes, it's time.
Oh, time to end. All
I
right.
I just wanted to see if anyone in the world was doing something really cool before we ended. It seems like it's pretty much peace in the world. Special forces, Qing Empire, yeah. But yeah, I still hope you enjoyed this episode.
Yeah.
And so hopefully next week 2 hours.
Hopefully next week 2 hours, and we will make sure the world burns.
Yes.
Burns hard.
We will wash the mountains with the Don Kubani blood, I guess.
Yeah, probably. And what happened in Ukraine? They are a kingdom now. Was there always a kingdom?
Yes, right. But I feel like that's a different king than we were looking before. I'm not sure.
It might have been. Anyway,
there is so much lore here.
Yeah,
we can play several sessions.
I'm like super excited for when this mod is completely done.
Yeah,
where everyone cool new focus trees and hopefully less of the event.
Yeah,
stuff.
Like last I heard, did they actually? Can we just switch to Sweden? Do we have like 1 minute? Because I heard something about them working on Swedish stuff now. Oh,
wow.
Look at that! It's a fully Swedish one.
Holy crap!
Those are full Kemet stuff I saw on the left.
I kind of need to do something with this.
Oh.
Anyway, I guess we can look it through next time.
Oh, look at that. It's the amazing old Saab logo from from like the old Saabs. It's the nicest Saab logo. They don't have that one anymore, sadly.
Anyway, thank you guys for joining us, and I'll see all of you next time.
Yes.
Bye.
Bye.